Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll learn to identify linear function and exponential function using tables and graphs. Also, we will recognize situations showing linear relationship or exponential growth or decay. Now, we start with identifying the function using table. Now we know that in a linear relationship, there is a constant rate of change that means a linear function grows by equal differences over equal intervals. For example, let us see the following table. In this input-output table, we can see that change in x is constant, that is 5 minus 0 is equal to 5, then 10 minus 5 is again 5, and 15 minus 10 is equal to 5. So the intervals are equal, so we can see that change in input values is constant. Now let us see change in output values given by y. By way we can see 45 minus 30 is equal to 15, then 60 minus 45 is also 15, and 75 minus 60 is again 15. Thus, value of y is increasing by equal difference. So, there is constant rate of change, thus it is a linear relationship. Now let us see another table. Now in this table, again we can see that change in x is constant, that is 5 minus 0 is 5, 10 minus 5 is 5, and 15 minus 10 is also 5, so the intervals are equal. Now let us see the change in output values. Now here you can see y is also increasing, but not by equal difference. Now here you can see 1200 minus 1000 is 200, then 1440 minus 1200 is 240, and 1728 minus 1440 is 288. So y is not increasing by equal difference, therefore here the relationship is not linear. Now here we see the ratio of consecutive values of y, that is 1200 upon 1000, which is equal to 1.2, then 1440 upon 1200 is again 1.2, and 1728 upon 1440 is also 1.2. So we can see that the ratio of consecutive values of y is constant. Thus, it is an exponential function, and this ratio is called factor. So, exponential functions do not have constant rate of change, but they have constant ratios. So we say that exponential function grows by equal factors over equal intervals. Now we can also identify the linear and exponential functions from graph. Now we know graph of linear function is a straight line, but graph of an exponential function is a curve which is either increasing or decreasing and it does not intersect x-axis. Now here, see the three graphs. Now the first graph is a straight line. So this graph shows a linear function. Now the second graph is an increasing curve. So it is exponential function. Showing growth and the third graph is decreasing curve, so it is exponential function showing decay. Now we will recognize situations which show exponential growth or decay or which show a linear relationship. Now consider the following statements. Statement 1 is given as, a cell phone company has following plan. It charges $59.95 per month for 700 minutes and $0.25 for each additional minute. And statement 2 is, Sam starts an experiment with 7,500 bacteria cells. They increase by 30% every hour. After 4 hours, there are 21,421 cells approximately. Now we have to identify the type of relationship. Now see in statement 1, the cell phone company charges fixed amount of $59.95 per month for first 700 minutes. Then it charges $0.25 for each additional minute. Now we form its expression. It will be C is equal to 0.25 into M plus 59.95. Now this expression shows monthly cost of calls given by C. The call charges will be 0.25 for M additional minutes plus 59.95 fixed charges. Clearly, it shows a linear relationship. With constant rate of change given by 0.25. So in statement 1 we have a linear relationship. Now in statement 2 we are given that bacteria cells increase by 30% every hour. So there is percentage growth rate. Now let x represents number of hours and y represents bacteria population. Now when x is 0, then we have initial population y is equal to 7500. Now population is increasing by 30% every hour. So when x is equal to 1, then population, that is y, is equal to 7500 plus 30% of 7500, that is equal to 7500 plus 30 upon 100 into 7500, which is equal to 7500 plus, now here 75 into 30 is equal to 2250. Now adding, we have 9750. So when x is equal to 1, then y is equal to 9750. Now when x is equal to 2, then y is equal to 9750 plus 30% of 9750, and on simplifying, this is equal to 12675. Now when x is equal to 3, then y is equal to 12675 plus 30% of 12675, and on solving, this is equal to 16477.5. Now when x is equal to 4, then y is equal to 16477.5 plus 30% of 16477.5, and solving, this is equal to 21420.75, which is approximately equal to 21421. So we see that after 4 hours, there are 21,421 cells approximately. So here we have obtained this input-output table, where x represents number of hours and y represents bacteria population. Now it will be an exponential relationship. Now let us see the rate factor for conservative values of y. Now when we find the ratio of conservative values of y, we see that it is constant. So ratio is constant, that is 1.3. thus we have same factor. So it is an exponential relationship. Thus in an exponential relationship, the quantity grows or decays by a constant rate percent per unit interval related to another. So in this session we have learned how to identify linear and exponential functions using tables and graphs. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.